needs to investigate cases in a time-bound manner, for I believe that no victim or their families should be subjected to prolonged agony of delayed investigations. Sir, I recoil with horror, not just as a member of this House, but as a woman and a mother, at some of the instances recounted by the Honorable Minister today. And as for those who are questioning the justification of death penalty in this House and outside of this House, I want to ask, is even the death penalty enough for the evil perpetrators of this horrific, monstrous and barbaric act? As a mother, I would say no. And I would like to ask you to just imagine what the families and the parents of those victims go through, and maybe what they would like to see happen in these cases. Sir, POSCO needs to be implemented swiftly, and also keep in mind the sensitivity and care of survivors. I have a few suggestions, sir, to the Honorable Minister through you. That child psychiatrist's presence to be made mandatory during each investigation to aid and advise, and also, especially in cases of female victims, the questioning should be done under female supervision during all times and every time. Offenders, sir, are punished once, but the victims are punished repeatedly during the interrogation, during the course of interrogation, and I think the sensitivity in the approach during the procedures of this becomes very important. That's why I feel, along with the differing punishments, the victims and survivors should be ensured utmost sensitivity and safety while during the course of interrogation. With these words, I conclude.
Thank you,
and
thank you very much, ma'am.
Bill wholeheartedly.
Sri Hanuman Beniwal. Please, advance caution, please.
10 minutes.